here we are, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the Join Dota League finals of the Asia Premier Division. You've got Scythe, the Singaporeans, going up against Mith.trust. The Thai boys going to be making a run for the money this time around, because it's no stranger to the CA scene. Well, Scythe, that is. And, well, especially with a frontman miracle, the draft of the mastermind behind the picks, it's going to be rather hard for them. But they've got Lakels, one of the best carry players in the business. So we most likely going to be seeing a Lakels Morphling against a Naga Siren of Miracle in one of those three games we're going to be watching. It's a best of three, so no more two-game series, no more 1-1, like, ties, no more crap. We're going to have a winner tonight. And I'm not sure if you guys know how the format works. We're going to have some sort of bubble race. So we've got the fourth and the third playing against each other right now, which is Scythe against Myth. This is coming up right now. Then we have, in 3 days, we're going to have Titan waiting for the winner of this game. And then 3 days after, actually 4 days after, so on the 13th April, we're going to have Arrow Gaming waiting in the Grand Finals, which are all best of threes, which are all going to be pretty damn awesome. Because whoever wins this, facing Titan, this is no easy feat, and especially Arrow Gaming, they're looking so incredibly strong. Just yesterday, they won the Dota Talk Open Cup pretty convincingly against MSI EVGT. And yeah, Arrow Gaming are looking very, very strong. And especially in the last few days, there was a bit of media around Lance, who is the carry player for Arrow. And he was like, yeah, you know what? We're just trained so much that we are actually getting so much better, like, each and every day. And this is no surprise that they just crush everyone. But we have to keep in mind, Titan, they're playing in WPC Ace right now, and they're looking very, very strong, I have to say. Especially against the... like, against Newbie, they didn't look that great, but it's Newbie after all. Like, Newbie's freaking great, and... well, this time around, we're going to have Scythe against Myth, a very high-profile tier game. Also, there are going to be a lot more games coming out, especially tomorrow. We're going to have RQ against the Australian team SICK. And this is around the Division 1 to 2 player. So whoever wins this game is going to go to the Loser's Bracket Final of the loser against Execration against Invasion. And who wins this is going to go into the Premier Division. Who loses this is going to be in the Second Division once again. So the Australians do have a shot at making it to the Asia Premier Division. And, well, I wouldn't be too surprised, but this is a game coming up tomorrow, so this is going to be very kick-ass as well. And I can't wait to cast it. Actually, no, this isn't tomorrow. This is scheduled for in 2 hours. But I'm not sure if this is right. Let me check my calendar. We've got a nifty calendar. Heat Umbrella, my boy, made it. That's pretty damn awesome. No, okay, so it's not coming out today. It is coming up tomorrow, 13th CET, Rex Regium KM against March of Mesaic. Definitely check this out, because this is going to be pretty nice to see if those guys can make it in the Premier Division and playing against the huge names. That is Titan, that is Arrow, that is Scythe, and even Orange. Also, Orange kind of didn't make it, and it was Mith.trust in the last few games making it out of the group here in the fourth place. And it's pretty nice to see. I like it. Also, is my Dota TV sound on? No, it's not. Okay, hello everyone from Dota TV. I'm sorry I had my sound muted in Dota TV. Now you should hear me. That's always a problem if I actually play the game once in a while when I have time, because I have to kind of mute myself because I'm in Skype. And yeah, this happens. Okay, fellas, so actually looking at the draft now, we got a lot of discussion about the Join Dota League, how the format's going to run. Now let's check the draft out, because we've got a very nice Naga Siren ban. Going up against Scythe, you don't want to face the Naga Siren. You just do not want to face it. Miracle is one of those guys. He's playing the Naga Siren to perfection, and he was actually the guy who just made a splash into the scene with a Naga Siren in the Chinese team and just crushed everyone. Now he found his home in Scythe. Didn't work out in Titan, but so far I like him very much in Scythe. He's playing with his old buddies from First Departure. And yeah, we're gonna see how this turns out, because so far there's no Miracle hero really picked up, but there is many possibilities for this guy to just pick up a very nice hero, crush everyone, and look pretty good at that. So we've got an Ancient Apparition first pick, that's kind of standard. Central Warner as well as a Shadow Shaman just following up, that's very standard as well, very great control. If you have Tranks and the Blink deck up on the Central Warner, you're gonna crush phase. There's nothing you can do as an AA, nothing. He's gonna blink on you, he's gonna stomp you, he's gonna double-edge into your face, few out attacks in between, and you are dead, because you're an AA and not tanky at all. Also, Shadow Shaman, just a very nice hero in general. If you win a teamfight and don't deploy the Raster Wards, you're gonna take at least one tower. Guaranteed, each and every time we win a team fight, that's huge. And yeah, this is just very nice and also interesting. Mith.trust valued the Clockwork above the Ember Spirit. team pick. And this is rather interesting. Not only is the Ember Spirit first pick material in pretty much every scene, not only the European and the American scene, no, also especially the Southeast Asian scene. But somehow, Mith.trust, they just want to go with the Clockwork. And this is rather rare, I have to say. And let me just check something here for Mith.trust. 10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds okay, remaining. Yeah, exactly, Mith.trust, there you go. Wonderful. Reserve so, time. Also rather interesting bandsite against Mith.trust. The Spectre is one of... Wow, Wisp, holy crap. Okay, so the Spectre is one of those heroes Lekkels plays very, very well. So, Lekkels Spectre is just like one of those heroes you don't want to face. He's going to be farming, obviously, because he's Lekkels. He's known for his Morphling plays, you know, he's known for his hard carry plays. But eventually, he always knows exactly when to join team fights and when to not join team fights at all. Like, he's going to pop his ult, he's going to evaluate exactly, do I want to go in? Do I not want to go in? Where do I reality in? Okay, you know what? I'm just going to go for it. And these are the small things which are going to be making you just very good as a player. Judgment. The skill to just exactly know when to do what. This is judgmental skill. It's not mechanical skill, it's not last hitting, but it's just experience as well. And, well, against the Mirana, against the Center Warrunner and the Shadow Shaman, you kind of have to be very, very careful. If you're not careful with doing... Oh, wow, and we've got a Chibi Enigma. Love it. If you're not careful with how you just do that stuff, you're gonna get crushed. And, well, so far, it's rather interesting. Mith.trust, they do pick Wisp from time to time, but it's by no means a stable pickup, and we've got Chibi's Enigma. So Chibi was a carry player and a mid player in First Departure, which was pretty much the whole team before Scythe picked them up, except for Chibi, for Lubby. And instead of Lubby, it was X-Freedom joining them. So we've got pretty much all of the First Departure boys here. And Chibi played a wonderful Mirana, just great mids in general, good Dragon Knight, all those heroes you do want to see in the mid lane. And now, well, he shifted to a 4 position, and his Mirana is spot on. It's like so freaking good, and I wouldn't be too surprised to see some like 3, 4, 5 man black holes this time around. And I'm not Toby, sadly, because I won't have a voice if I do this once, but yeah, maybe if the opportunity is right, there could be something. And yeah, this is a dinker. This is actually rather standard from Mith.trust. They love their tinkers. Like, so much. And if you think about it, you're gonna have a Clockwork who's got 2.5k initiation range, which is essentially half the map. You're gonna have a Wisp TP with you, so you can bring two heroes with a Wisp, you're gonna have Tinker with a BOT, Clockwork who can just run wherever you want to gank, and an AA ultimate. This doesn't look like a gobbled strat, but boy, it is. It absolutely is. And Mith.trust are gonna be not seeing any sort of Tinker, any sort of Morphling. Good banner by side, because this would have been for sure the last pick from them. Just how well actually Lekkels played this Tinker. And I'm not sure who's going to be handling the Tinker. It looks like it's going to be a mid-Tinker from ABBA. But they've got quite a few guys who can actually play this. So I wouldn't be too surprised to see them either. So what is the last pick going to be for Scythe? They are lacking a carry right now, and the Miracle Mirana could be inbound. I'm not sure actually. Because Mirana could also go mid and do perfectly well. But what are they going to be picking up? I really want to know, because they do have some sort of lockdown, but against the just I come at your face sort of thing from the Wisp, I feel like they lack a bit. And it's an anti-mage, yeah, this is a Miracle anti-mage. Wonderful. This is exactly how Scythe is going to play this out. This is a Scythe draft, if I ever saw one. And also Mith.trust, both teams, they don't want to draft against the other team, they just want to go with what they're comfortable with. They want to just have good lanes. Well, good lanes with an anti-mage and Enigma in the jungle is kind of hard, right? But against the Wisp, you can go greedy. The Wisp doesn't have the biggest lane presence on level 1, 2, 3. At all. 10 seconds remaining. So you might as well just go greedy. And this is some sort of quad-core lineup we see a lot from Orange. So they like to run a 4-position Doom. This time around it's going to be a 4-position Enigma. And this Enigma is going to have farm. Like, Chibi usually doesn't gank too much, he just ganks exactly so much that he's right. Like, that he actually crushes the lane. So whoever goes offlane, and it's most likely going to be the Clockwork, because aggressive Trident with a Wisp and an AA? No. This is absolutely not how you want to play this. Yeah, so you could just Zone out the clockwork, go back into the jungle, farm up your blink dagger, farm up your mechanism, farm up your soul ring, whatever you want to go for it. And also, we saw a few enigmas going not for a soul ring, but rather for the arcane boots for the team. And I absolutely like it. Wow! And this is also rather interesting. Yeah, it's going to be ABBA on the Tinker, obviously, and Lekels Chaos Knight. Okay, so Lekels doesn't like to play his Tiny, obviously, because otherwise he would have picked the Tiny, because in my opinion, at least, the Tiny is just an all-around better pick than the CK. You don't rely too much on your RNG, and the CK not only has a 2 to 4 a stun who scales from 2 to 4 seconds, and it's all RNG-based, no, he also has a auto attack, which is like 45 to 75. It's ridiculous. And getting last hits with this boy is sometimes just a pain in the ass. But it's Lekels, he plays it a lot, and I wouldn't be too surprised to see him just running away with the whole game. And I like it. Against the anti-mage, you need lots and lots of lockdown. You're gonna have a clockwork hook, you're gonna have an AA, just with the deeps. And anti-mage, he's got a spell shield, but he doesn't have any strength game whatsoever. So if you just single him out, you are gonna have a great time. And yeah, this should be great. Let's do it like this, so I actually see what's happening. Great. Prepare for battle. So, let's go ahead and introduce the players. On the side of Scythe, we've got the one and only Miracle G from Singapore. He's going to be handling the anti-mage, and he's looking very fancy with his blades. Having pulled one ward, which just means it looks like he's going to go solo. Mid lane, or well, not mid, but at least in the jungle, it's going to be Chibi on the Enigma. Polson is most likely going to be handling the mid Mirana, because ABBA... Where is he? Oh, never mind, he's on the other team. Just a brain fart there. Hana on the offline Centaur. We've got, of course, X-Freedom, who's an Infinity sign here, as is Nick. And which leaves none other than... No, we actually introduce everyone. Never mind, I'm still sleeping, don't worry. So we've got Lekels, the number one position carry here by Mith.trust. He's going to be handling the Chaos Knight, joined by FTG, who should be Boombell, I think? I'm not sure if he changed name or if it's another player. So this should be Boombell. Anyways, FTG on the Ancient Apparition, TNK on the Wisp. Mid lane, well, it's going to be a safe lane Clockwork, interesting by KYT. And of course ABA on the Tinker. So no fun is to be had, Miracle. If he gets a great start, if he gets a very early Battle Fury, he's going to have a great time, and the fun ends when he gets his Battle Fury up. But it is hard, because split pushing against the Wisp is always not easy, and especially against the Tinker, who's going to have a Blink, who is going to have, well, a Scythe at one point. This is hard. And also, this is rather hard. Mith.trust, man, they're gambling. They're just rolling the streak here. So not only... This is not only a flush, this is a straight flush. This is exactly how you want to play this out. Have Miracle right here. Because Miracle would win against the Clockwork. And he would do very, very well. So what you do, you just go aggressive troll and bank on the fact that the Clockwork is going to be right here. But this leaves mid very vulnerable, because you're going to have a great gank path. And ABBA doesn't have too much on level 1. Polson doesn't have too much as well. So he doesn't have any skill point put into anything so far, so he's gonna have a leap on level 2 as well as an arrow, or well, just an arrow and a star storm, depending on what they want to go for it. But there's already Scythe having the Shadow Shaman position very well here, so X-Freedom can just rotate in, and they're gonna find FTG. If they go now, they have to go right now. Chibi, oh no, it's gonna be Boombell, they're gonna find him, and he spotted them out, and it's gonna be ABBA running to the bottom rune, very smartly played. And man, that was kind of lucky here that FTG just happened to run away there. He was just scouting things out. He was like, just casually running through the jungle, and he was fine. He was absolutely fine. Also rather interesting how top lanes look in. Because KYT should have... Well, he should do well against the Centaur, but both should actually get some farm up. And wow, look at Miracle. He's already dropping rather low here. So Wisp-Spirit gonna be scouting him out. And those things hurt, man. This is only a level 1 Wisp-Spirit, but they are like 25 hero damage x5, so you're gonna have 125 magic damage on level 1. This is not like a disruptor, but it's still very, very good. So now CS-wise, actually the Centaur is looking incredibly strong. 8 for 6, not 8 for 7 now, but still. And it's obviously that Lekels is actually farming as well. So Lekels is doing very well. We're gonna be seeing if he goes into the armlet rush. If he goes no armlet, maybe just treads drums. maybe just a fast BKB. But usually, of course, we're gonna see the Armlet. Armlet is just such a strong item in general. You're gonna pop the Armlet, pop your ultimate, and they're gonna have all the stats from the Armlet. They're gonna have all the deeps, and they're just gonna crush phase left and right. And there's gonna be a bottle flying out in the Grieveling. Golden Baby Roshan. That's cute. Mr. Freedom, having some fun here. And now there goes the Marchbomb. So ABPA not gonna be going into any sort of 2-2 X fighting build. He's gonna be just giving lots and lots of grief to this Mirana, pushing down the tower, harassing down with a laser, and now Miracle in a lot of trouble. He's got no CS. Zero. So game is gonna be hard for Miracle. Really hard. But the thing is, this is still Miracle who we're talking about, and he's... I saw him like twice on the Anti-Mage when he got just shut down completely, and he still bounced back. He still got a... well, not the best Battle Fury, obviously, because you just get destroyed in the lane, but you're gonna have your Battle Fury eventually, and even if it's a late Battle Fury, you're still gonna have lots and lots of creep scams to just clear. You're gonna have all the lanes, and you're just gonna crush people in the CS chart anyways. You need some time, yeah, but who cares? And I've got a pause. Also, fellas, if you want to have some specific stats up, you can write Pimp or Pimpmuckl in chat and just say whatever you want to have right after. So, like, Pimpmuckl, please put up net worth. And I'm going to be hitting that Z button. That Z button. And I'm going to be bringing up. You're going to have a few other stats you can just request. You're going to have... yeah, you can just request also a gold graph. You can just request whatever you want. I'm going to be putting it up. Also, if you've got any feedback for me casting, please shoot me a tweet. Because this is the thing I usually read most, which is on my bottom right-hand side of the screen. It's at Pimpmuckl. Would be deeply appreciated. And then we're going to be picking up Miracle. Is he in a bit of trouble? Nah, he's absolutely not. He is absolutely not. And Wisp doesn't have the most harass right legs, but still, it's alright. Like, eventually you're going to harass him out. And now Hana, there's a cold feed, not going to be latching onto him. Oh wow, well, they still have to be kind of careful with the battery assault. It's a level 2 battery assault, so if they just get him and... oh, there's not gonna be any sort of procs here. Very nice hoof stomp onto KYT, but still. That's not enough damage. There absolutely is not enough damage at all. Wow, my throat. Anyways, the big thing here is, though, Scythe is splitting farms so much. Yeah, and we already see this, like... Anti-Mage can't find anything, but there's going to be always Chibi, and Chibi is farming away nicely. There was an arrow attempted. Cute play. Not going to be latching, though. And, well, Enigma with a mech and a blink dagger can just do wonders against this lineup. Especially if you think about it, if there is going to be... well, if you pick up the Clockwork in your Black Hole and he doesn't have the battery sold up, you're going to crush face. Who else is going to cancel your Black Hole? Chaos Knight with his measly... what is it, like... yeah, this isn't, like, too much range. Reality Rift has a bit more, but it's still not great. So, Chaos Knight, if you just pick up a few guys in the Black Hole, the Wisp can't stop you, the Tinker can't stop you for a long-ass time, the AA can stop you, but it's a cold feat. I mean, it has to proc first. So this is way too much waiting time, and by then, your whole Black Hole is gonna be channeled through and everyone will be dead. Especially with the Mana Void. The new Mana Void has got ridiculous AoE. So even though Anti-Mage isn't picked anymore, he's still a very viable pick, and it's a very strong pick if you can actually play him to perfection, which is exactly what Miracle is doing, usually. But yeah, this is pretty much exactly it. And pair that with the Shadow Shaman, Hana's gonna have his double edge and all that up. And he's gonna just crush face. And our mid lane, there's gonna be some Mirana ultimate trying to get used here. And they're going to be finding ABBA in the jungle, but they're going to be revealed rather soon here. One more second, and they can't find him. And it's actually a first blood onto KYT. Wow! Holy crap. 6 minutes in, and we finally got a first blood. I didn't expect this at all in the top lane. Especially not without a level 6 in the Shadow Shaman. Well, next thing you know, someone's dead. No Rampage being called as well. They just didn't need it. Oh, wow, and Shibi is just doing some crazy work here. So he's just dealing stacks left and right. If he picks up the Dark Troll Summoner, this is already a huge win. And he's gonna get it. Nicely done there. So much gold going in his pocket. And yeah, now FTG though, he's smoked up. Can he find someone though? Oh, he's not smoked. It's an Invis rune. And Miracle has to be very careful. He's just waiting here. But now there comes KYT. Chibi getting stunned up by the battery assault. This could be kind of huge if they get the kill onto the Enigma. But so far, nope, not fast enough. And Chibi's just wrapping around each and every time. He's gonna have his Malefice up. Oh no, ABBA, a few more right clicks from Polson. One more. He has to get him. He has to get him. He's got a leap. He's leaping forward. And he finds him. This is gonna be another kill. 2-0 now on the board. 4 side. Well done by Polson. And KYT doesn't have a hook shot. This hurts him so much. He could have taken up the kill on the Enigma. He could have given it some fire support here to his mate ABBA, but it just isn't happening. He needs this level 6 and he needs it bad, and this is all coming down to how Hana just picked him up, and Hana's now level 7. Levels are looking rather good. Of course, still anti-mage, but he's level 6 as well. So that's alright. That's alright. Levels are still looking rather good for Scythe. But well, now there comes your push, and this is gonna be hard to hold. I mean, the Eidolons are not that high level. What is it? Like, it's a level 2. Yeah, so level 2 Eidolons is not too big so far, but this is already okay-ish. So you can take down towers, you can just pressure towers, and this tier 1 in the mid lane is rather crucial. Against the Tinker, you want to take down towers before he can get up his BOTs, his Blink Dagger, and be this annoying, well, thing to deal with, where you just can't push in. Whenever you push in, there's gonna be like double marches laying down. And you can't push? And wow, look at this timing. It's an 8-minute Blink Dagger onto Hana. No Tranquils. Who needs it if you just crush people left and right? He's now heading to the bottom lane. But mid lane, this is where the action is. KYT popping his battery assault. And this is where Chibi can't ult. And he doesn't even have the mana for it. He's got a buckler. And oh no, the Clockwork Hookshot kind of missing here. That's unfortunate. But Hana, oh man, Lakels has to be incredibly careful. Because there's gonna be a Moonlight Shadows initiation, and Hana's got his, yeah, he's got his Blink, he's got his Stomp, and he's got the right clicks, and Lakels is in a world of hurt, 3 seconds cooldown, and there goes the ultimate. Lakels is so slowed, one more right click, and Hana's gonna be picking this one up. That's a huge kill, that's a big kill, and now this is where Miracle starts to just come back in the game. Yes, he's got 10 CS, it's 8 minutes in, this is not the Miracle farm you wanna see, but he's coming back now in like huge steps, and well, mid lane is getting pressured as well. FTG waiting in the wings, TNK as well, just trying to do some wisp harassment here. And they're picking it up, they want to go. And in the meantime, top is getting pushed in, bottom is getting pushed in. So all this pressure on the map from Scythe, they're looking so good so far. But here they go. It's a double rocket spam up onto Polson as well as Chibi. And ABBA is so low, he has to be incredibly careful that he doesn't get hit by an arrow. Well, by anything. Polson's got a DD, he can just go for it. He's gonna pull a 3-2-2, he's gonna lead with the Star Storm, and the right clicks are here. Is he gonna take a fall? No, it doesn't look like it so far. Oh no, KYT's gonna have a hookshot. Cancel it in the last second, can Polson get away? Does he have a leap? No, he does not. Arrow, and the hookshot right on the mark. Nails him down, slams him home. And it's a 1-for-1, but well, if you go in into 4, you might as well expect that you actually die. Oh, X-Freedom waiting top lane, and there's Hana coming in as well. The Central Warner has got a blink, we have to remember. And with the Rust Awards as well, the Kels could be in a hell of a lot of trouble here. And now the Centaur also has got his Tranquil Boots up, so he can just use his double edge to farm. And this is the YOLO build. Boost Stomp, 2 points in there. 4 points in the double edge, so you essentially just crush yourself if you jump in, but they want to make a go here. This just screams, we want to kill the Kels once again. And he's going for the drums, it's a smart pickoff, and here they go, it's a blink forward, it's a stun, it's Chibi hasted, and they go in, it's a, what a black hole, they're going to take down 4, it's a 4-man black hole, make that 3 kills, make that 4 kills, they just kill everyone, it's Freedom with a triple kill, and this is how you play this game, they say. Chibi just immaculate play, what an insane black hole. Hitting onto 4 people, just crushing them all down, and all this AoE coming out. Polson was joining the party as well. He just rotated top lane, and Chibi with the haste making the huge blaze, and they're gonna take down a tier 1 as well. Holy smokes! Man, that was like so good. Chibi, man, commend this guy. Yeah, man, like this is why you pick Enigma, just to see some amazing black holes. 4 people in there, and it was just perfect. I mean, TNK, he had to ult there, he had to go in, he had to save Lakels. But in the end, it just didn't work out at all. But good thing is, 11 minutes in, and we've got ABBA with his BOTs up. And they're gonna be flying in his career right now, so he's gonna have this up. But Enigma's got a mechanism up, so they've got so much pushing power. And look at the net worth, like, Chibi is doing so incredibly well. Miracle? Oh, ABBA knows he's there, he finds him, and there's a Clockwork Hookshot. Miracle doesn't have a jump away. Oh no, he gets blown up. And that's a huge kill going the way of Myth. Still though, Miracle doesn't need to carry. Well, yet. Because you've got Hana, who's just crushing people left, right, and center. You can have the Murana. Poulsen is just looking very good as well. Oh no, an arrow from downtown is going to be helped here by Freedom. And oh no, Poulsen gets exploded, but a very nice shackle. And Freedom, KYT doesn't have his battery sold. He can't find it. He gets stunned in the face, though. Freedom. Oh, they don't have Reveal. And they're out. Oh, picking up the regeneration rune. Such a close call there. And still, the Kells. Are they really want to make a go here? Seriously? And all in the midst of things, Yo was taken down top lane because they knew where he was, where he would come back. And he was just here, getting blown up. Oh man, what a game. We're 12 minutes in, 10 for 2 on the board, Scythe is looking rather good. Checking the gold graph, yeah, they're just crushing people. So we've got an 8k gold lead for Scythe, as well as a 7.5k experience lead. But this is still doable, I guess? It's gonna be hard. It's gonna be really hard. And I'll look at Anti-Mage. His CS just skyrocketed. Like, as soon as they left bottom lane, he just made some pretty sick CS. But now top lane, this is where the action is gonna be. ABBA laying down the marches. He's got a soul ring, he's got everything he needs. And they're just running straight into a ward of Mith.trust. Very well placed ward. They know exactly how aggressive Scythe wanna play this out. He's battling with Chibi, 30 seconds on his ultimate, and then he's gonna go in and, well, deploy most likely another pretty amazing black hole. They're pinging out ABBA, I'm not sure if you want to go for it. I am absolutely not sure if you really want to go for this one here. Well, anyways. Smoke picked up on the Ancient Apparition, and they have to make stuff happen. Like, Mith.trust, yes, they do have a Tinker, and Tinker is just scaling amazingly well in the late game. But going up against this farmed lineup of Scythe, you usually play Tinker against some sort of so single core, so you can't just Scythe with someone up and just bring him down ASAP, refresh, repeat, you know? But, I don't know, like, everyone is just so farmed. Hana's gonna have his pipe up really quick, and then everyone else is gonna be farmed as well, and they're gonna be finding the Kells. It's a 3 second stun onto Chibi, he's gonna have a black hole. Is he gonna use it? No, he doesn't even need to, they just explode the Wisp, and they're gonna be finding more Kells on the run. Can he go away? Absolutely not. And there is KYT hooking in, gonna take one down, but for what cost here? They can't double edge, they can double kill for Hana. And now FTG's on the run as well. Here comes ABBA with a march, maybe not, no, okay. And they're just gonna be wrecking face left, right, and center. Still, Poulsen not even dying from this kind of overextension here. And everyone is so low, everyone! Holy crap! ABBA, arrow in his face? No. And man, is Scythe playing well. 13 for 3 on the board. They certainly just pulled the game together. Dire's middle tower is under attack. They had some questionable losses in the JDL group stages. But we have to keep in mind, these are best of twos or two game series, so you just play two games each and every time you meet each other against each team in the whole group stage. So you might as well just experiment a bit here and there, and this tournament doesn't have the largest prize pool. We are on like over 8k prize money right now, which is pretty much all featured by the community. That's pretty damn nice. And yeah, if you didn't pick up a ticket as of yet, there are still playoffs going on, and you're still gonna get the games from the... how do you put it? It's the up and down matches. Oh no, they got top lane. The Kells arrowed into his face. And there could just... there could be just so much action. Oh, Miracle blinks away. Gets away. Close call there. Yeah, but there was a point I tried to make. Exactly, like JDL. So the ticket is €3? No, $3 or €2.19, which is not much for like... hundreds and hundreds of games played, actually. So you might as well still pick it up. It's still a good value item there. And you're still going to be increasing the prize pool, which is going to be going to 100% to the teams. And now it's going to be the Ancient Apparition. It's a Blink. It's a Hoofstomp. It's a Double Edge, I imagine. Nope, absolutely not. It's going to be Miracle taking this down at the roster wards. So no overplay, no overextension as of yet at all. And they're just going to go and take down this tier 2. And they're gonna be finding more. Is there any sort of blink? Yes, there is, onto TNK. He gets stunned, but he's in the tether. It's another black hole just onto 2. What a nice hookshot! He gets 3, but he's gonna die for this. It's Poulsen on a dominating. It's X-Freedom on a dominating streak. Everyone's just dominating. And they're gonna crush people so hot. Holy smokes! Man, and another very good black hole forcing the Clockwork Hookshot. It was a very good Clockwork Hookshot, don't get me wrong. But this is just hard. And Hana with a pipe. Everyone is just so tanky. So they've got the two big teamfight items up. Chibi. Yeah, so Chibi's got a blink dagger. Chibi's got a mech. Chibi is so freaking farmed. And also, Hana's got a freaking pipe. So he's farmed as well. So, tower report. We've got tier 1 standing still. Order them for Scythe. Mid, top, left, bottom, right. Whatever. Each and every tier 1. Oh, bait him? No, not gonna be baiting him. On the side of Myth, we only have one tier 2 left. And this is the problem. If you don't push towers, you're gonna have a gold disadvantage. And it's gonna be rather severe. This is really big. Yeah, and this is why the gold graph looks so good. Oh man. 17k gold graph, 16k just around the corner. And we're gonna have like 13.5, 14k experience lead as well. Oh man, and look at Miracle Man. He's still got a 17 minute freaking Battle Fury. He got no CS 8 minutes in. Like, none at all. And he got Treads, he's got Battle Fury. He's looking so good. And they're gonna take down more. Bye bye, KBT. You're dead, son. And Lan should be rather amused. This is also very nice if you're waiting in the grand finals. You're just gonna watch all those games and you're gonna exactly see how everyone plays it out. So Lance, of course, is the carry player for Arrow Gaming. And well, if you just go and see two best of threes for the teams you're gonna face, that's great knowledge. This is exactly how you wanna play this out. Still though, it's a CA team, so everyone knows each other quite well. And oh, Link forward, ABBA. Has to be very careful that he doesn't get caught out. And these are just casual wrecks, so pretty much no defense coming out. The AA ultimate is going to be helping out a bit, but they see it and they just go and fall back. There's a counter ward deployed, but for what end? And they just call it. They just call GG. Wow. Well, that was a quick GG. 80 minutes in, and this was absolutely it. A bit more killing going on. While I just wanted to give you the panorama of this wonderful shrine. And this was the first game. And I'm dropping frames, I'm sorry. But anyways, this was the first game of a best of three. Stay tuned, people, for more Dota 2 action coming your way on the Daily Community channel. You're gonna have Scythe against Mith.trust game 2 coming up in just a bit. So stay around, and yeah, don't go anywhere. We're in the second game in around 2 to 3 minutes. Stay tuned. Also one thing, follow me on Twitter. It's on the bottom right-hand side of the screen. Follow me on Facebook, it's the same. Twitter and Facebook.com/Pimpmuckl. If you enjoyed it and if you're watching from the VOD, please give me feedback in the comment section below. Bye-bye, guys. See you in the second game.